Chapter 9. Rose and Margaret. In all of Cedar Springs Forest, Christina Bee felt sure she had never seen any creature as pleasant as the two young ones that stood before her. They were small with long legs, longer than those of Reggie the Fox. Their ears were large and, like their mother's, turned constantly to listen to sounds that were inaudible to Christina Bee. Large, dark eyes remained fixed on Christina Bee for what seemed like the longest time. The two youngsters had no real sense of fear about them, but they were cautious and terribly curious about this buzzing black and yellow creature which had entered their world. Like Reggie, they sniffed at the air with almost the same intensity, but with more pauses. "Hello, I'm Christina Bee," said the little western honeybee, introducing herself to the somewhat timid pair who were now trying to hide behind their mother's legs. The mother didn't speak. She just lowered her head again and continued nibbling on the tender grass shoots, all the while listening to the world around her with those ears that moved constantly. As the mother relaxed, so did the youngsters. They stepped closer to the little honeybee, giving Christina Bee a better look at the attractive coats with which they were clothed. Their fur was brown, dotted with white spots. Some of the spots were arranged so closely they looked like they were in lines along the length of their bodies. And they each had a tail, short and constantly wiggling. Looking into their deep dark eyes, Christina Bee was certain she had never seen anything that looked as cute as these two sisters. At last, one of them, the elder of the two sisters, spoke up. "Hello to you too. I'm Rose, and this is my twin sister, Margaret. We're fawns, Alabama white-tailed deer fawns."
"I'm pleased to meet you both,"
responded Christina Bee, somewhat sleepily. For Christina Bee, the day was drawing to a close. Her energy was getting low, and she settled among a patch of nearby flowers. As she disappeared into the flowers in search of nectar, Margaret's curiosity got the better of her, and she stepped closer to get a better look at what Christina Bee was doing. Just as Margaret put her nose to the tip of the flower Christina Bee was drinking from, the little honeybee emerged with a muffled buzz that startled Margaret so much she jumped almost as high as she stood. Margaret's reaction caused both Rose and her mother to instinctively leap back away from Christina Bee. The quietness of Cedar Springs Forest was instantly disturbed by the loud rustling of leaves and the sound of heavy feet stomping the ground. In a moment, though, tranquility returned, and with a nervous laugh, Rose attempted to settle everyone down.
"Never mind that, Margaret," she said. "She's a little jumpy. Actually, we both take after our mother."
"It's okay," said Christina Bee. "I'm sorry I startled you, Margaret." "I'm sorry I'm so jumpy," apologized Margaret. Without a word, Rose and Margaret's mother turned her ears to listen to something in the distance. She lifted her head and slowly walked in the direction from which the sound was coming.
"It looks like we have to go," said Margaret.
"One day Mother says we'll each grow up to be a real deer, just like her," said Rose.
"For now, though, we're too young to be out by ourselves. We'd better get going."
"I'm sure we'll see you again," added Margaret.
"I hope so."
"Goodbye," responded Christina Bee. Christina Bee remained settled among the patch of flowers. The day was wearing down, and it had been a busy one. The sounds of Cedar Springs Forest were changing as evening drew on. A blanket of noises from a different band of creatures was taking over the twilight. Croaking sounds from Cedar Springs Creek played with the imagination of Christina Bee. She had never spent time around the creek this late in the day, and had never met the creatures who were making these noises. She decided she would explore the creek another day. For now, she was too tired, so she headed for home. Just as she drew close to her home in the beech tree, she was distracted by a sound coming from the edge of the creek, which sounded like someone repeating the word, "Billy, Billy, Billy." As tired as she was, she couldn't stop herself from taking a peek at what was producing this sound.